What did it mean? The original man, not the original spook, put it out there. So going there with us would be a small step. But for that kind of man, who is non-original, giant step for him. White folks prove that God is real. He's not a mystery. He's as real as you sitting there, me standing here, you sitting there. God is sitting there, me standing here, you sitting there. All you have to do is envision it. Believe in it. And then get others to believe with you. And work your vision. And soon the vision will become a reality. God is real. You are real. We can change the reality of our lives if we understand we are all gods. We are all gods, children of the Most High. He walks, he talks, he thinks, he acts. He even grieves. So what do you read the Bible for? Because the God that's in the Bible, he's very real. Let me quote some passages for you. We got to get this spiritual thing straight now. You ready? Abraham is the father of the righteous. He was in the plains of Mamre, according to the Bible. And three men came to Abraham. And Abraham, scripture says, one of them was who? The Lord. I didn't write it. It's there. Abraham got up. He addressed the Lord. He said, Lord, if I have found favor in your sight, pass not away from me. Sarah, fix some food. The Lord may be hungry. Draw up a chair for the Lord. He may want to sit down. But how could he sit down if he don't have nothing to sit down on? Could he sit down if he don't have nothing to sit down on? After his likeness, and you are real, and he's a spook. After his likeness, and you are real, and he's a spook. So listen, when you realize that there is no such thing as a mystery God, you're not gonna sit at home and pray for bread and wait for a loaf to fall down on your table.
you're going to pray to God, that's the right thing to do. Oh, God, guide my footsteps. I don't want bread for a day or bread for a week. I know, Lord, I ask you to give us this day our daily bread. But thank you, Lord, for giving me the mind to buy 2 acres of land in the right zone of weather. Thank you for pointing me out to the wheat seed. Thank you for pointing me out to the wheat seed. Thank in a few months comes the wheat. Thank you, Lord, for showing me how to take that wheat and grind it into flour. Thank you, Lord. I got the wheat now. It's flour now, Lord. I think I'm gonna make me some bread. Thank you, Lord, for showing me how to use fire. That's cause and effect. We can change our reality. That's the point. I'm not against religion. We're against tithes taught in the name of religion or religious misunderstanding of Scripture. Dead ought to be raised, and you are the dead that got to be raised. Look at you. Look at you. You know, dead people, you have to fix them up. And you can't keep them out too long, because they will start smelling. I know you love your family as I love mine, but death tells you, let's have a ceremony. Let's pay our respect and let's bury our dead. But thank God. Thank God. Daddy's gone, but he had a son that looked just like Daddy. That's how you live into the future. You live through your children. And that's why abortion is a crime against the future of a people. To the womb. You didn't hear me. I'm going to have to say that one more time. Ah.
dear sisters. Your womb is sacred. Don't allow man to enter that sacred chamber. If he's not worthy, why would you give him? See, when a good man is in your life, you don't mind having a child for him. You delight in having his child. Because you know he's going to help you. You know he's going to support you. It really hurts when men can take advantage of you and laugh at you. And walk away from you. And walk away from the babies that you are now bringing into the world for them. Don't do it. You're better than that. Command. Brothers. The command of God is that we must protect. Respect and control. Let us have prayer. Boy, you can say respect, you can say protect. But the worst thing in a man's language to say to a woman is control. That sets it off. So before the women rush me and give me a deserved spanking, I have to make plain what I mean by control.
Back. Hey, hold on.
You're the woman of
God. I'm about to look into this shit.
Not the woman of man. And you know, when you fall in love with a man, I'm talking about real love, you see some of God in him.
Wait a second. So you. That's true. The new neighbor?
You see some of God in him.
Yeah, man. Let us know if you need anything. No, we don't need anything. As a matter of fact, you know, just try to keep it down. You know?
The more God that's in him, the more you submit to him. The less God that's in him, you walk away from him. Now, why control? If we are under the control of God, then our family should have peace under the control of man who's under the control of God. Because if we are under the control of God, we will never abuse control of our women and children. Now, brothers and sisters, look, there is a hierarchy in family. Why do you think the Native Americans have so much to teach us? Because they have such genuine respect for women. At least they did. Some of them are messed up like we are right now. But
the ceremonies are men trying to equal themselves up to the pain that women have to bring life on our planet. She dies to bring life to birth. The pain of birth is equal to the pain of death. So every woman that brings children into the world, how many children? She has died that many times for the advancement of man beyond this time. I am finite, and I don't want to stay around forever. Forever. Long time. But let me tell you something. See, when you see the cycle of life keep going, I remember you. You were just a little baby when I saw you. Now he come up and he walking with his child. How many times will you see that same cycle? Oh, clouds. I saw that before. Oh, mountains, yeah, rivers, valleys, I've seen all of that. And the foolishness of human beings, I've seen that too. Haven't you heard some of your loved ones say to you, sweetheart, I'm tired. Listen, they love you, but they're tired. Listen, they love you, but they're tired. Live. We get tired of life. Living in live. We get tired of life. Living in pain. So death becomes sweet. And your parents would set it up. Mine set it up. I didn't want to hear nothing about my mother dying. She said, boy, sit down. She gave me instructions. I wrote everything down. She gave me instructions. I wrote everything down. She wanted me to carry out her instructions. I never failed. Not one jot, not one tittle of my mother's instruction as she was leaving the world. And some white man, I know it was white, by saying that she tried to abort me 3 times. I wasn't. By saying that she tried to abort me 3 times. I wasn't. When your baby's under the bus, I was trying to help you to see the value. If I was aborted, where would you be today? My life has value. My life has purpose. And so does the life that is in your womb as we speak. That's how God answers prayers. So